if you know a startup founder who's gone through a fundraise, just go and ask them how much time did it really take them to close the deal after the investor said, hey, I'm ready to put in the money, and send them a term sheet. The answer in most cases would be nothing less than 4 months. That's because there is so much compliance and paperwork involved. After the term sheet, where, you know, terms are defined in definitive agreements such as your shareholders agreement, your share subscription agreement, then valuations are carried out by registered valuers, where they look at projections of the company and do a discounted cash flow or a DCF valuation. A lot of such strange and, you know, first time heard terms come to the knowledge of the startup founder, and he's just like, I was expecting money to hit the bank within 15 days. How is it that it's taken 4 months and I need to open a separate bank account where they'll send in the money? Then we'll file certain forms with the ROC, which will get approved, after which I can use it. Now, in a lot of early stage startups, there is no way that you can also even value the business. There's a possibility that you've just started off, your company has just been incorporated, and there is no traction, there is no product for you to do this arbitrary valuation on. Also, the founders don't even have 4 months of time to get going, because should they be using funds at this time to build the product or just keep doing paperwork? Which is why a simple instrument or a security which has come to the benefit of a lot of startups is called convertible note. Now, this convertible note is a concept started in the Silicon Valley by a bunch of, you know, accelerators, Y Combinator, and a bunch of other angel investors who collectively developed this and thought, we'll use this. Now, what does a convertible note really do? It doesn't require your startup to get valued by a registered valuer. It is in the form of a debt. So essentially, what an investor is doing, saying, hey, I'll put in, for example, 1 crore in your startup today. I don't know what value your startup has. This is in the form of a debt. You're supposed to give me a small amount of interest on it, which will accumulate over a period of time. Now, say this period of time may be within the next 5 years. So the next priced round that you have, or say in the next few months, which could be 12 months, 18 months, whenever, you have an institutional investor or a VC fund valuing your startup after you've got some traction, you've built the product. So the first time when the valuation is actually going to happen of the startup, my debt or the money I've given to you in the form of the convertible note is going to convert into equity shares at the first time after issuing of the convertible note when the startup is valued. How does this conversion happen? Now, of course, there's a possibility that, say, I invested money in an early stage startup, about 1 crore rupees, and 1 year later, the valuation is going to happen. So the valuation is going to happen, say, they get a valuation of 5 crore 1 year down the line. But I invested 1 crore at a point where the company had no value at all. I would say that if a new investor is getting shares at a 5 crore valuation, I should actually, if my 1 crore is converted at 5 crore, that means I get 20% equity. However, I took bigger risk by investing in the startup at a time when the startup had absolutely no business, no product, which is why I should actually get more than 20%. Which is why the convertible note has a term that says that my issue of equity shares, which I will get 1 year later, will convert at a discounted value. So say this discounted value is 20%, which means when the company gets valued at 5 crore 1 year later, the discounted value after 20% discount would be 4 crores. And my conversion into equity share will be at that discounted value, which means my 1 crore over 4 crore, I'll get 25% of the equity, and not just 20% of the equity, which essentially means that this discount is such an important part of this convertible note that, you know, that's where the early stage investor really gets a higher share for investing in the startup at a time where there was only the idea, but not really a product per se. Traditionally in India, these kind of startup fundraises have happened in the form of compulsory convertible preference shares, compulsorily convertible debentures, all of which require some kind of valuations to take place. And the paperwork is pretty taxing, to say the least, which is why convertible note is a simple agreement. It can be something as simple as a 5-page agreement stating that these are the terms at which this amount of money which has been put in by the investor, which has to be a minimum of 25 lakhs and no less, and the company in which you're putting in that money needs to be a startup registered on the DIPP platform or the Startup India website, as you guys know it. In this case, this agreement of a convertible note can be drafted. There will be minimal secretarial compliance or paperwork to be filed with the ROC around it, and a startup can actually continue to raise money through convertible notes and use it to build the product. There are very little but very important differences between compulsorily convertible debentures, compulsorily convertible preference shares, and convertible note. Know that convertible note is something which is only used in the early stage when you cannot value the company and you don't have as much time. That's the stage. Share it with a startup founder who's just starting off and wants to know what convertible notes are. I googled and I found a lot of links which give so much confusing information around this that it's important. If you really want to do this issue, please speak with a chartered accountant or a lawyer who knows how to do it. Share it with someone who may need it.